Hello students, welcome to the class on concepts of network. The objective of this session is to orient you towards the concepts of network, to study the concept of network, that is net etiquettes, searching the web, meaning of search engines and keywords, also to study the advantages and disadvantages of net etiquettes. So, let us start with the introduction. So, first of all, we must see what is etiquette. Etiquette in technology governs what conduct is socially acceptable in an online or digital situations. While etiquette is ingrained in culture, etiquette in technology is a fairly recent concept. The rule of etiquette that apply when communicating over the internet or social networks or devices are different from those applying when communicating in person or by audio such as telephone or video phone such as Skype video. It is a social code of network communication. Communicating with others via the internet without misunderstandings in the heat of the moment can be challenging, mainly because facial expressions and body language cannot be interpreted in cyberspace. Therefore, several recommendations to attempt to safeguard against this misunderstanding have been proposed. The concepts on the networks are net etiquette, searching the web, meaning of search engines and keywords. So, let us start with one by one. Net etiquette. Etiquette is a set of social convention that facilitates interaction over networks ranging from Usenet and mailing list to blogs and forums. Net etiquette or net etiquette refers to etiquette on the internet. Good net etiquette involves respecting other privacy and not doing anything online that will annoy or frustrate other people. Three areas where good net etiquette is highly stressed are email, online chat, and news group. For example, people that spam other users with unwanted emails or flood them with messages have very bad netiquettes. You don't want to be one of those people. If you are new to a news group or online chat room, it may help to observe how people communicate with each other before jumping in. Etiquette in technology governs what conduct is socially acceptable in an online or digital situation. While etiquette is ingrained in culture, etiquette in technology is a fairly recent concept. The rules of etiquette that apply when communicating over the internet or social networks or devices are different from those applying when communicating in person or by audio or video phone. It is a social code of network communication. Communicating with others via the internet without misunderstanding in the heat of the moment can be challenging, mainly because facial expressions and body language cannot be interpreted in cyberspace. Therefore, several recommendations to attempt to safeguard against these misunderstandings have been proposed. It is a set of social conventions that facilitates interaction over networks ranging from Usenet and mailing list to blogs and forums. Like the network itself, these developing norms remain in a state of flux and vary from community to community. The points most strongly emphasized about Usenet net etiquette often include using simple electronic signatures and avoiding multi-posting, cross-posting, off-topic posting, hijacking a discussion thread, and other techniques used to minimize the effort required to read a post or a thread. Similarly, some Usenet guidelines call for use of unabbreviated English, while users of instant messaging protocols like SMS occasionally encourage just the opposite, bolstering use of SMS language. However, many online communities frown upon this practice. Common rules for email and Usenet, such as avoiding flame wars, that is derogatory, insulting messages or interactions, and spam are constant across most mediums and communities. Another rule is to avoid typing in all caps or grossly enlarging script for emphasis, which is considered to be the equivalent of shouting or yelling. Other commonly shared points, such as remembering that one's posts are or can easily be made public, are generally intuitively understood by publishers of web pages and posters to Usenet. Although this rule is somewhat flexible depending on the environment. On more private protocols, however, such as email and SMS, some users take the privacy of their posts for granted. One-on-one communications, such as private messages on chat forums and direct SMS, may be considered more private than other such protocols, but infamous breaches surround even this relatively private media. For example, Paris Hilton's Sidekick PDA was cracked in 2005, resulting in the publication of her private photos, SMS histories, address book, etc. Let's start with online etiquette. It is a term that describes how a person should act while using digital technology online, and has also been defined as the ability to participate in society online. The term is often mentioned in relation to internet safety and netiquette. The term has been used as early as 1998 and has gone through several changes in description as newer technological advances have changed the method and frequency of how people interact with one another online. Classes on digital citizenship have been taught in some public education systems, and some argue that the term can be measured in terms of economic and political activities online. Searching the web. The search engine that helps you find exactly what you are looking for to find the most relevant information, video, images, and answers from all across the web. A web search engine is a software system that is designed to search for information on the World Wide Web. The search results are generally presented in a line of results, often referred to as search engine results pages, which we called SERPs. The information may be a mix of web pages, images, and other types of files. Some search engines also mine data available in databases or open directories. Unlike web directories which are maintained only by human editors. Search engines also maintain real-time information by running an algorithm on a web crawler. The first tool used for searching content as opposed to users on the internet was Archive. The program downloaded the directory listing of all the files located on public anonymous FTP, which we called File Transfer Protocol sites, creating a searchable database for file name. However, Archive search engine did not index the contents of these sites. Since the amount of data was so limited, it could be readily searched manually. Indian version of the search engine search the web or only web pages from India. Offered in English, Hindi, Bengali, Telugu, Marathi, Tamil, Gujarati and Kannada. The search engine that helps you find exactly what you are looking for. Find the most relevant information, videos, images and answers from all across the web. A web browser, commonly referred to as a browser, is a software application for retrieving, presenting and traversing information resources on the World Wide Web. An information resource is identified by a uniform resource identifier, which we called URI, and maybe a web page, image, video or other piece of content. Hyperlinks present in resources enable users easily to navigate their browsers to related resources. Although browsers are primarily intended to use the World Wide Web, they can also be used to access information provided by web servers, in private networks or files in file systems. Meaning of search engine: computer program that searches databases and internet sites from the documents containing keywords specified by a user. Some search engines allow inclusion of Boolean operators such as AND, OR, NOT that make a search specific and faster. Google is the most popular search engine in today's world. A program that searches for and identifies items in a database that corresponds to keywords or characters specified by the user, used especially for finding particular sites on the World Wide Web. Search engines are programs that search documents for specified keywords and return a list of documents where the keywords were found. A search engine is really a general class of programs. However, the term is often used to specifically describe systems like Google, Bing, and Yahoo. Search that enable user to search for document on the World Wide Web. Web search engines. Typically, web search engines work by sending out a spider to fetch as many as document possible. Another program called an indexer then read these documents and creates an index based on the word contained in each document. Each search engine uses a proprietary algorithm to create its indices such that ideally only meaningful results are returned for each query. As many website owners rely on search engines to send traffic to their website and entire industry has grown around the ideas of optimizing web content to improve your placement in search engine results. Learn more about search engine optimization, which we called SEO, in this definition. Common search engine types. In addition to web search engines, other common types of search engine includes the local or offline search engine designed to be used for offline PC, CD-ROM or LAN searching usage. Meta search engine, a search engine that queries other search engines and then combines the results that are received from all. Blog search engine, a search engine for the blog of Spear. Blog search engines only index and provide search results from blogs, or we called as a web blogs. Search engine optimization, or SEO, is the process of affecting the visibility of a website or a web page in a web search engine's unpaid results, often referred to as natural, organic or earned results. In general, the earlier or higher ranked on the search results and more frequently a site appears in the search result list, the more visitor it will receive from the search engine's users, and these visitors can be converted into customers. SEO, or search engine optimization, may target different kinds of search, including image search, local search, video search, academic search, news search, and industry specific vertical search engines. As an internet marketing strategy, search engine optimization considers how search engines work, what people search for, actual search term or keywords typed into search engines, and which search engine are preferred by their targeted audience. Optimizing a website may involve editing its content, HTML and associated coding, to both increase its relevance to specific keywords and to remove barriers to indexing activities of search engines. Promoting a site to increase the number of backlinks or inbound link in another search engine optimization tactic. As of May 2015, mobile search has finally surpassed desktop search. Google is developing and pushing mobile search as the future in all of its product, and many brands are beginning to take a different approach on their internet strategies. Here some search engines have also reached out the search engine optimization industry and are frequent sponsors and guests at SEO conferences, charts and seminars. Major search engines provide information and guideline to help with site optimization. Google has a sitemaps program to help webmasters learn if Google is having any problem indexing their website, and also provides data on Google traffic to the website. Being webmaster tools provides a way of webmasters to submit a sitemap, and web feeds allows user to determine the crawl rate and track the web page's indexed status. Let's start with the keyword. Keyword in the context of search engine optimization is a particular word or phrase that describes the contents of a web page. Keywords are intended to act as shortcut that sum up an entire page. Keywords form part of a web page metadata and help search engines match a page to with an appropriate search query. The role of keywords was once very central to the function of search engines. Search engines could crawl sites, and if the keywords were accurate, serve those sites up as search result. However, people began abusing the keyword metadata in attempt to show up higher in searches and even to rank in completely unrelated searches. For this reason, the importance of keywords in search engine optimization has been greatly reduced. Keywords are arguably still an important factor, but they are not the only factor in search engine optimization. Search engine optimization, or SEO, refers to methods used to increase traffic to a website by increasing its search engine page rank. SEO often involves improving the quality of the content, ensuring that it is rich in relevant keywords, and organizing it by using subheads, bullet point, and bold and italic characters. Search engine optimization also ensures that the site's HTML is optimized such that a search engine can determine what is on the web page and display it as a search result in relevant searches. These standards involve the use of metadata, including the title tag and meta description. Cross-linking within the website is also important. Search engines attempt to rank results for a given search based on their relevance to the topic and the quality and reliability a site is judged to have. Google, the world's most popular search engine, uses an ever-evolving algorithm that aims to evaluate sites in the way that a human reader would. This means that a key part of search engine optimization involves ensuring that the website is a unique and relevant resource for readers. The methods are common ways to improve a website's search engine optimization. These methods are called white hat search engine optimization because they aim to improve search rank by improving the user's experience on the website. Increasing keyword depth, increasing interlinking, improving the organization of content on the page. Black hat search engine optimization involves techniques such as paying to post links to a website on link farms, stuffing the metadata with non-related keywords, and using text that is invisible to readers to attract search engines. This and many other black hat search engine optimization tactics may boost traffic, but search engines frown on the use of such measures. Search engines may punish sites that employ these methods by reducing their page rank or delisting them for search result. Now, start with the keyword stuffing. Keyword stuffing refers to the practice of inserting many instances of particular keywords into web content to try to get better search engine ranking. It involves putting keywords into web pages as well as inserting them into item like headers, meta tags, and meta descriptions. Although there is no rigid rule on how many keywords constitute keyword stuffing, experts suggest that the practice is apparent in reading text or even in reading meta description or other attachments. The key is that keyword stuffing often appears extremely inorganic because keywords are inserted in places where they do not belong. This practice of keyword stuffing becomes more transparent and easy to explain in the context of long tail keywords, which are longer keyword phrases that often have four or more words. In fact, new Google algorithms punish the stuffing of long tail keywords more than the stuffing of shorter ones, partly because the former negatively affects the readability of text. A simple example is the use of a keyword phrase such as cooling technician specialist in Miami, Florida. Stuffing the keyword would include sentences and paragraphs that refers to a cooling technician specialist in Miami, Florida, where the full phrase is not needed or where it does not line up with the natural flow and punctuation on the text. For most readers, it is easy to see where one or more of these instances have been added, because it does not read right or look right according to our perception of how text is written. New practices by the dominant search engine, Google, have made keyword stuffing rather obsolete and ineffective in gaining search engine results. However, throughout the last two decades, as the internet grew, keyword stuffing was a common and almost acceptable practice for trying to get better standing of Google search engine and other search engine results to reach more readers and deliver more page views. So, let's start with some of the advantages of net etiquette. So, the first advantage of net etiquette is it enhances company profile among industry peers, provides additional sales tools, improves professional skills, promotes cross-cultural awareness, fosters dignity and respect in the workplace, provide positive impact on workplace code of conduct, and also improves internal and external customer relations. So, these are nothing but the advantages of net etiquette. Let's see whether we have a disadvantage of this or not. There are no disadvantages of net etiquette. Using a proper etiquette, individual can be themselves around their family or friends, but out in society, whether it's going to school, working, going to special events, one should know proper etiquettes or manners. The advantages are that your personality mixed with proper etiquettes tells another person that you are a well-polished person, and it shows you care by how you act in public situations. Many individuals will take more notice to a person that cares about etiquettes, their own manners, and often good opportunities may come their way, whether it's for entertainment purpose or possibly a good job offered to a person. Let's come to the conclusion. Etiquette is a code of behavior that portrays expectations for social behavior according to contemporary conventional norm within a society, social class or group. Etiquettes are set of social convention that facilitate interaction over networks, ranging from Usenet and mailing lists to blogs and forums. Students, with this we have finished discussing about the concept of net etiquette. we also learn about advantages and disadvantages of net etiquette. With this, I would like to conclude this session. Thank you.